Welcome back to the 11 Labs Agents Academy. In the previous videos, we've looked at creating our very first customer support agent, embedding it into our website, and adding some server tools to look up order status and information. In this video, we'll look at client-side tools. The great thing with client tools is that we can allow the agent to take actions on the client side. So for example, if the agent is integrated into our website, the agent can navigate the website between pages, could change, toggle dark mode, light mode, whatever you can imagine. You can give the agent access to the DOM, you can trigger UI events, or if you integrate the agent into the mobile apps, you can also trigger notifications or access kind of native tools within the mobile apps. So let's have a look at how we can add client tools to our application. So if you remember, we had our e-commerce websites here where we had the server-side tool that could look up our order information to, give the customer information about the status of their order. Now let's imagine we want to integrate that more deeply into our website and actually allow the agent to add items to the cart, for example. So that is something we can do with client tools. So here you can see we're using the use conversation hook, and we can provide our client tools to our use conversation here using the React SDK with 11 Labs. So we have two client tools here, our add product to cart. So our product to cart requires a product ID as well as a quantity. And then finally, we also need another tool here is get the product ID by the name, because obviously the user won't know the product ID. So they'll just say, oh, please add kind of the wireless headphones to our cart. And then we'll need to look up the product ID there. Okay, great. So let's go back to our store assistant agent here. And there's a couple of things we'll need to modify. So first of all, we will need to add our tools in the tools section of our agent. So here we can say add tools, and specifically we'll want to add a client tool. And so now we can look over into our application. So we had two tools here that we specifically wanted to use. So we had our add product to cart. So that's the first one here. And we'll describe tool to add a product to the cart using the product ID and quantity, okay? So in this case, we will want to wait for the response, and we'll do, we won't need that long of a timeout, but kind of a 5-second timeout here. And then we'll need to add some parameters. So first of all, we have here our product ID. So the product ID is kind of product ID's number. So we can add the identifier here is the product ID, and then we can copy here product. Then we can say here the ID of the product as a full integer. So in our case, these are kind of full integers. Okay, product ID. Okay, great. And then the product ID is one parameter, and we have another parameter here, which is the quantity. It is optional, but we'll just say this is a number. This is the quantity of the product as full integer. Defaults to one. There we go. And then we'll save that. So now our tool is updated, and then we'll save this as well. And then we have one more tool, another client tool. Now, getting the product ID by a name could also be a server tool, obviously, if we wanted to look up the product on the server. In our case here for this demo, we'll just have it integrated on the client. So get product ID by a name. That's a tool to add, get the product ID from a product name. And then we'll have one parameter here, which is the product name. And that is the name of the product. Okay, great. And let's add that tool, save that. So you can see now we have our two client tools added here to our agent. Now, another thing we need to do is we need to update the system prompt to know about our tools. So here in the tool section, we can say specifically, you have access to two client tools, one being our add product to cart, and two being get product ID by name when the user asks to add a product to the cart. First, use the product ID by name to get the product's ID. Then use add product to cart to add the product to the cart. Fantastic. There we are. Let's give that a save. And so now we can try this out to our products. Well, we'll see that here. And so now we can see, okay, let's run this. So here, if we add a product to the cart, we can see it's being added to the cart here. Let's clear the cart for this. And now we can talk to the agent. Okay, let's give this a try.
Hi there, I can help you track your order, add items to the cart, or answer questions you might have.
Yeah, hey, can you please add two of the smartwatches to my cart?
I can help with that. To confirm, you'd like to add two smartwatches to your cart?
Yes, that's correct.
I'm sorry, I couldn't find smartwatch. Did you mean smartwatch? There's also wireless headphones, designer backpack, coffee maker, running shoes, and desk lamp.
Yeah, the smartwatch, please.
Great, I've added two smartwatches to your cart. Is there anything else I can help you with today?
Yeah, can you also add one pair of the running shoes to the cart, please?
Okay, I've added one pair of running shoes to your cart. Anything else?
That's it, thanks so much. Great, so now we can jump into the conversation and we can look at the most recent conversation here. And so in the transcript section, we will see the tool calls that are being made by the agent. So we can see here that it was trying to get the product ID by the name. So it was looking for smartwatch, didn't find kind of smartwatch exactly. So it got back, kind of a list of products that could be related. So it confirmed, yes, the smartwatch, please. And so now in this case, we're getting the details for the smartwatch back. Now, obviously, this could be a server-side tool as well, hooked up to kind of your database with your product catalog. And now here we're calling the add product to cart with the product ID 2 and the quantity 2. And you can see successfully added two times of the smartwatch to the cart. So there we go. You can see how the client tools are being called here and how the parameters and the responses are being shared back with the LLM, and it's very natural kind of within the conversation.